The display on this thermostat is obviously bad. If you look at the hour, tens of minutes, those are fine. You go into the single minute display, and that's where the problem is. Now to access the menu, you press the up and down button simultaneously. Once you make sure the thermostat is set for 52 degrees, press up and down. And the first thing you'll notice, you'll see Wednesday is gone on the display. Wednesday's out, and the single minutes display is bad. Other than that, the thermostat works. Once you're into the menu and you get to the first option, you can just press the down button, and you can see that the heat works. Switch it over to cooling, press the down button, contactor pulls in, you see the snowflake in the display. It tells you that it's calling for cooling. And that's how you get away from the, or get around the delay, 5 minute delay on for compressor and cooling mode. And also adjust, I have no idea what that is, I really don't. All I know is it shows that that portion of the screen is bad. You can display Fahrenheit or Celsius. And you can also adjust the cycles per hour. That should be an H there, but that portion of the display is bad. And you can adjust it 9, 12, 1, 3, 4, 5, 6, 9, 12 cycles per hour. Default is 6. And no idea what that is. Don't really care. And another, showing you again, that portion of the screen is bad. And now we're out of that. And again, make sure you're set for 11 degrees Celsius. Press your menu. Wednesday's gone. And we'll go back to Fahrenheit display. And to exit the menu, you have to keep scrolling through it. That's how you get out of the menu. Now the crappy looking 8001 actually works. Actually, they both work. Heat, cool, fan modes, they all work. This one just happens to look like crap. And to get into the menu, once again, make sure you're set for 52 degrees. Press up and down. The entire display lights up, so I know that display is good. And this one does the same thing. Set it for cool. It'll turn on the cooling. Set it for heat. I'll bring on the heat, see the little flame icon, and turn that to off, and might not be able to see that, the fan switch actually works. That's a mechanical switch that almost never fails, so I'm going to see about taking this thing apart and taking the good parts out of the ugly one and putting it in the pretty one. Good luck to me. Yeah, the T8001 is capable of working with a heat pump system or electric heat system. There's no on-screen menu option to change that. There's actually a switch here in the back. F for fuel, fossil fuel, and the opposition is electric, which is used for heat pump. And another interesting thing, Honeywell goes out of their way to say do not remove screw. I'm not sure what that means. I'm pretty sure they meant to say do not remove screw with a Phillips screwdriver. Use probably something, I think that screw is like somewhere on the order of a T10, but I'll just use a 1/8 inch slot screwdriver. So Honeywell needs to fix that. Do not remove screw with Phillips screwdriver. That's what they meant to write on there, but they just didn't have enough room. I forgive you, Honeywell. It'll be okay. Yeah, both thermostats set out. The gnarly one, the dirty one, the manky one, whatever you want to call that. And I got the nice one. And I just sat them on a towel just to protect the face, because eventually I want to come out with one good thermostat. And your eyes are not fooling you. I have a pink dish towel. You got a problem with that? Okay, removing the screws, and have to have a magnet. Don't want to lose them. God, does my eyesight suck. It's really horrible. It's amazing I can see to wipe my own ass. Okay, remove the back. Set that aside. Remove the board itself with switches, and I notice there are more screws. One, two, let's see. Okay, one, two. Yeah, at least two more screws I shouldn't be removing, but I know I will because I'm like that. And this is the retention device that holds the screen in place. Just remove that, and the screen comes with it. And there's that little band I tried to clean up, that little connector. That display is just bad. And buttons come out, but I really don't need to remove those. And this thermostat has a window on it, so you don't directly touch the screen. Now that the other one opened up, and I could just replace the screen, but I'm just going to replace all the internals because I don't know if the old thermostat, I don't know if this board is bad or not. The contacts look good, but I'm not going to take a chance. I'm just going to swap all the innards and come up with one good thermostat. Hey, get the screws out of the other thermostat. And there's one. And there's two. I know, should have used a magnet, but it's on a towel. The screws aren't going to roll away. So, remove the board. Set that aside. And pry up the retaining clip. Take that free. Darn it. It doesn't want to come out. And just drop that into the new. And just press that right back in. There's the board. There's the thermocouple. Sensing temperature. Line that up. That little notch right there. Line that up. Tuck it under, set that right in place, line that up, and screws off the magnet, right into place. Now all I have to do is tighten those down, throw it on the sub base, and wow, from dirt to gold. Beauty is a joy forever. So let's see what this thing does and what it looks like as it's doing it. 52 degrees into the menu. All the items are lit up, lit off. Set it for heat. It brings on the heat. Set it for cool. It brings on the cooling. Set that to off. And fan on. Absolutely gorgeous. Throw the other screen in the trash and take that other board apart. Just because I'm curious. I've got a T8 screwdriver. Came in a cheapy jeweler screwdriver kit. Yes, made in China. Oh, here we go. Oh, boy. It's like Christmas morning. I've got a magnet. Last screw onto the a magnet. Okay, what do we have? We got some mechanical contacts with some grease on them. Keep the contacts clean. And the underside looks nasty. Got this grease all over it. Keeps the contacts clean and lubricated. Yeah, big deal. Nothing special. I was hoping for more. Oh well. Fan switch, system switch. Off heat cool. I don't know where the terminals correspond on the base here, but obviously match up with something. I'm really unimpressed with that. And there we go. I got one good thermostat and another one that's kind of good. It doesn't look all that great, but it does work. Lane display. I'm really proud of myself for this one.